watched my husband lug this huge tree with thorns on it inside. So he knows what he has to do. He and my son do it. Let's pick this one right here. And again, I mean, this is a huge lemon. Okay, here we go. Wow, and there it is. Look at that. Look at that. You can't even see like my hand. So look at this beautiful lemon. And we're gonna cut this open and see, and I'm gonna make some candied lemon peel and some candied lemon slices and a lemon cake also, because I like to bake. Here is my Ponderosa Wonder Lemon, and there is the regular just table lemon. So let's just see how much this weighs. So lemon number one is coming in at 3.5 ounces. This is coming in at 25 ounces. So 3.5 versus 25 ounces. So let's cut open the lemons to see how they compare. First, we will do the table lemon. Okay, nice, beautiful lemon. Nice and yellow, seeds in there. And now, first I can barely even like lift this with one hand. It's hard for me to get my hand around there. So I'm gonna lay it on its side and I'm gonna cut this open. Okay, here we go. Almost through. Oh, wow. That is like so cartoonish. Look at that. This is the pot. And then I just got a huge like waft of this beautiful, bright lemon scent. I'm gonna give you a close up. So look at that, just tremendous, just tremendous. Okay, now let's sit them side by side again. So grocery store lemon. And I'm gonna call this organic home garden lemon. Okay, so grocery store lemon, Ponderosa Wonder Lemon. And look how thick the skin is on there. We're gonna get tremendous flavor out of this. Just tremendous. Because I wanna take some of this citrus. Some of it I'm gonna candy, like in whole slices. And then the rest, I just want the rind, and I'm gonna do like some thin strips of just the skin. But just to make it a little bit easier to cut, I'm gonna take out some of these seeds. And I recommend that you actually buy a tree, because if you just plant a lemon seed, you can get, like trees are ultimately like not the best, like you don't know necessarily if you're gonna get fruit, but if you get like a graft from a tree and get it like that, then you'll definitely like get some fruit. Okay, how about we juice these? Okay, so let's see. Not even a quarter cup. That's about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Okay, I have finished juicing this huge lemon. Remember, table lemon versus Ponderosa Wonder Lemon. And from the table lemon, I got like maybe 2 tablespoons of juice. So let's see how much juice I get from the Ponderosa Wonder Lemon. So Ponderosa, this was actually a hybrid that was pioneered in Italy. So let's see how much juice we get. And I was almost right. We have almost 1 cup of lemon juice from this lemon. So now I'm gonna kind of just cut this into like some wedges. And it's just releasing that beautiful fragrance. So look how wide the pith is. It's like a half inch. So I'm actually gonna cut these down a little bit more. And I'm gonna take some of this out. Okay, so that's more reasonable. I even might go a little lower. Okay, so here's our prepared skin. And I'm just gonna cut this into like slices. And it's so fragrant. I wish you were here. Okay, and look at this great pile. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to get some nice, like maybe 1/4 inch to 3/8 of an inch slices from here. Wow, look at that. So maybe if I start this way. Table lemon, ponderosa lemon. Okay, so the next thing I will do is put these into some cold water and bring them up to a boil and let them simmer for 15 minutes. And that is hopefully gonna reduce some of the bitter taste. So here is the citrus, and I'm just gonna get it into the pot so that we can get the water boiling and get some of the bitter taste out. So first, let's just take a look at that. So I'm gonna do them both together. I'm gonna do the slices along with the peel, like the strips, should I say. Okay, so I just have it covered. Okay, so when it comes to a boil, I'm just gonna turn it down. So continuing with the citrus theme today, I was at a grape store and they had some mandarins. So I peeled it very carefully, and I'm just gonna cut this up and we can get this candied also, but I think I'll do it in a separate pot. So I'm just gonna make some nice strips. So this is a mandarin, and look how deep the color is and how deep it goes into like the white part. So we're gonna cover this with water and bring it to the boil just like the lemon. Okay, it's been 15 minutes and the peels are done boiling. So I'm gonna drain and rinse these. So it's had a nice rinse, and you can see these are just a little bit kind of translucent. So now it's time to add the sugar and some more fresh water. So this is 2 cups of sugar. And I'm also gonna add 2 cups of water. And I'm just gonna bring this up to a boil and then add my peel back in. And also I'm gonna dissolve the sugar. This was the other peel. These were the mandarin slices, and since I've occupied the other one, I'm just going to drain these. So let's say 1/4 cup of sugar and some water. Okay, I have dissolved the sugar and the water, so I'm just going to add my peel back in. And once it comes to like a gentle kind of boil, I will reduce the heat and cook it down for, I've watched a lot of different tutorials, so they say about 1 hour. So we'll see how it looks in about 1 hour. And there is the mandarins. There are the mandarins. There are the mandarins. Starting to boil. Gonna turn it down so that I still have like some bubbles going. So this is our citrus. It's been going for about maybe 30 minutes. And according to the timer, it still has about another 30 minutes, but you can see that it's turned like quite translucent. I think I had too much water. So what I did was I took out this much water, which is almost a cup, and I put in like another half cup of sugar, and then I started to see more of like translucent color. And this is the canned mandarin. And I've actually added a little bit more sugar to this. So the candy citrus is done. It looks really nice and translucent. So I'm just gonna transfer it to this drying rack. I was hoping to maintain some of the, the middle part so it looked like a slice. But I think it's definitely candied. Okay, this one might be good. Just move off some of those smaller pieces. Okay, I'm happy with that. It's really delicious. Of course, it's bitter, but it's like, it's not impossible to eat. It's gonna be a great complement to a dessert. Okay, here is the candied mandarin rind. And this one looks like it reduced a little bit more. I gotta taste this. Oh, that's delicious. Mm-hmm. I highly recommend candied mandarin. Well, I hope that you enjoyed candying fruit today here at Style and Sugar. Don't forget to subscribe to see more of this content, and let me know what you think about this video. Let me know if you tried this out, because you know, ultimately we put so much citrus, we just eat the fruit and then the peel goes in the trash, and the peel just has like so much benefit, so much flavor. So this is the citrus. It's all laid out on the rack, and I'm gonna stick it in the oven so that it can dry out for 24 hours and hopefully it won't be so sticky to the touch. And I should mention the oven won't be on.